Dear Hubbard, thank you very much indeed. Not quite sure what I'm doing here, to be perfectly honest with you. I'm looking at the list of inspirational speakers down here, and lots of professors and doctors, probably more than anywhere in Cardiff, outside of Heath Hospital at the moment, I would imagine, a very impressive list. And I'm a man who kind of divorced from education once I went up to high school education. I didn't get on particularly well. I was more interested in skiving, going out and catching snakes and catching fish. So I feel a little bit like a fish out of water here. And I hardly ever write anything beforehand. I always think, right, okay, I'm going to go down by rail today, and I'll think about what I'm going to say on the way down. I'll look outside for inspiration, and invariably in Wales, you aren't going to look very far. You know, you look at the wonderful now, it's a brilliant time. The leaves are coming out, primroses, cuckoo flowers coming out as well. Unfortunately, this is about the sea and seabirds, and I came down the eastern edge of Wales. There wasn't a crab, any seaweed, not a fish in sight. There were pair-mating buzzards, which inspired me briefly, but when you get to my age, brief inspiration is all you can hope for, really. This is a very important conference. It really is, and make no bones about it, it's been triggered as well by the fact that funding has been pulled from a very important long-term Guillemot work carried out by Tim and other people from Sheffield University. And the feeling that I get speaking to NRW staff, speaking to other people, is that this is actually the tip of the iceberg, whereas we were promised initially when these three bodies were going to come together that there would be no cutbacks, that all the savings would be made in admin, in having one body rather than three. We're now seeing that that actually is not true. There will be severe cutbacks. And to cut back on such important monitoring work, on a national nature reserve, on our most important group of birds, to me seems ridiculous. When I go out and about and give talks, I don't give many these days, but I always ask, you know, which group of birds do you think is the most important group of birds we have in the UK? And you have various answers. People say woodland birds, and woodlands are important, of course. They're temperate rainforest, important for birds. In Wales, wood warblers, red stags, pike flies. We have an incredible array of lichens, mosses, liverworts, ferns there, but it's not them. People might say that it's the wintering waders and wildfowl we have. We have hundreds of thousands of them, and of course they're vitally important, they're internationally important, but it's not them. It's our seabirds. We are the envy of almost the whole of Europe. People come from far and wide just to see row upon rows of guillemots, an island covered in gannets. And when I ask people, okay, in Wales now, which is the most important bird, invariably it'll be the red kite, Wales's national bird, extinct everywhere else 100 years ago. Half a dozen pairs survived just in mid Wales. It's a good point, but it's not. It's not. It's the shearwater, the Manxie. We have over half the world's population on three Welsh islands. That's how important these birds are. And to mess around now, at a critical time, with key long-term monitoring, to me, at least, seems remarkably foolish. So that's just to set the scene for today. You're going to hear from a long list of excellent speakers, and speakers who are really at the head of their game, not just in Wales, not just in the UK, but worldwide. So once again, Lizzie, well done you for putting together such a fantastic conference in a fairly short time. Now you're going to hear from me at the end. I've been quite calm here at the beginning. By the end, my anger will have built up. I'll be red-faced, steam coming out of my ears. I promise not to swear, because this is on camera here as well. But I'll be back later on. Enjoy. Diolch yn fawr.